A red laser pointer emits light with a wavelength of 700 nanometers. A fancy green laser pointer emits light with a wavelength of 500 nanometers, which emits more energy per photon. So first, what equation are we going to use? Well, we're going to use the energy equation, which is E equals hc over lambda. Oops. E equals hc over lambda. Okay. H is Planck's constant, which is equal to 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34 joule seconds. Okay, C, as we said in the previous video, is the speed of light, which is a constant, 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. And let's see here, the wavelengths are given to us in the problem. We're given 700 nanometers for the wavelength of the red. It's wavelength of the red. And we're given 500 nanometers for the wavelength of the green. For both, we want to solve for energy, and we want to see which one has the greater energy per photon. Okay, so let's set up our equation. Energy equals hc over lambda. Now, before we go any further, remember what was mentioned in lecture and also in the previous video, that the speed of light is given in meters per second. The wavelengths given in this problem are in nanometers. So what do we need to do to these wavelengths before we can put them in the problem? Well, before we can put them in the problem, they have to be in the same units. Otherwise, things aren't going to cancel out. So the first thing that we need to do is to convert our nanometers into meters. The conversion factor is that 1 nanometer is equal to 1 times 10 to the negative 9 meters. So we have 700 nanometers. 1 nanometer is equal to 1 times 10 to the negative 9 meters. So we want our nanometers to cancel. This can be done without typing it into the calculator, but if you're not comfortable doing that, go ahead and type it into your calculator now. You should come out with an answer of 7.00 times 10 to the negative 7 meters. Okay? And obviously for the second one, it's the same thing. 500 nanometers, 1 times 10 to the negative 9 meters over nanometers. Nanometers cancel. Same thing, you don't have to type this into your calculator, but if you're not comfortable doing this sort of math in your head, go ahead and type it in. You should get 5.00 times 10 to the negative 7 meters. So now we have both of our wavelengths in meters. We're ready to go ahead and set this up. So again, the energy is equal to hc over lambda. H is 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34 joule seconds. C is 3.00 times 10 to the 8th, meters per second, divided by the wavelength. We'll start with the wavelength of the red, which is 7.00 times 10 to the negative 7 meters. So now, at this point, it's just a typing into your calculator. 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34 times 3.00 times 10 to the 8th. And we're going to divide that by 7.00 times 10 to the negative 7. Okay. And for the first one, we should get an energy of 2.84 times 10 to the negative 19. 2.84 times 10 to the negative 19. And what units is this in? Well, our meters cancel it out here. Our seconds cancel out here, and we're left with a unit of joules, which makes sense since we're calculating energy, right? And we're looking for units of energy, which would be joules. Now, we're going to do the exact same thing for the second. Exact same thing. So 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34 times 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second divided by 5.00 times 10 to the negative 7. Okay, let's type this into our calculators. 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34 times 3.00 times 10 to the 8th. Okay. We're going to divide this by 5.00 times 10 to the negative 7. And we get an energy of 3.98 times 10 to the negative 19. Again, let's see here, we have meters here. Our meters cancel. We didn't write units in here, but it was joule seconds, so our seconds cancel. And we are left with an energy unit of joules. Okay, so we have two different sets of energy here. We have 2.84 times 10 to the negative 19 and 3.98. The larger of these two is this one, right, which was our green light. So our green light emits more energy per photon, which, if you notice, makes sense because we have a smaller wavelength, right? And since wavelength is in the denominator, the smaller the number in the denominator, the larger the overall number you should get, especially since the top half of the equation, Hc, is constant. So you could have told me that the green one had a higher energy than the red one just by looking at the wavelength without actually doing any math, because the top of that equation is constant. So we're only looking at the denominators, right? So if you're looking for which one is larger, then you're looking for which one has the smaller denominator. Dividing by a smaller number gives you a larger answer. Thank you for listening.